So I got a card from her. Are we recording?
Yeah.
Ooh, okay. So, Jalen,
Yes.
Jalen,
Yes.
Jalen,
Yes.
we received something amazing in the mail.
We have.
Yes, it's amazing. It's from a lady named Amber Graham, and her shop is called Of Fell and Bone on Etsy. Of Fell and Bone. It's all one word, of Fell and Bone. It's but what she does is she creates dice bags from fur and leather. And she sent one to me. And I haven't opened it yet because it just when I talked to her, it was so like when we got to talking about it was so incredible. She gave me this card. And I always appreciate it when someone goes through the trouble of writing a card. Dearest Pickled Dragon, that's me, Dice Addict Jalen. Please know how grateful I am for the energy you are spending to help me. You know, and that's really when she told me about her project, and we got to talk about it, I was like, yeah, this sounds really cool. I really want to see it. And so she offered to make me a dice bag. And she asked me what I would want. I said, you know what? Why don't you surprise me? You're the artist. You just do what inspires you and show me what you got. So she put this little package together. It's got this card in it. And one of the things that she told me, a frequently asked question is, where do you get your supply from? And the answer is simple. She buys from Native Americans and a tannery in Washington State. And so it's a very humane way of acquiring her furs and leathers and so forth. And that's something that's very important to her. I don't want people to think that, you know, she's going out massacring animals to make dice bags, because that's not the case. She uses mostly scraps that are unused. And that's literally what she says here. I use small scraps as much as I can. And she also makes toys for cats using all
Aww.
these scraps. So it's really about making, the most use for of the animal hides so that nothing goes to waste. So, but it's very kind of her to write this note, you know. She also enclosed this. I have not opened this little scroll, this little parchment yet. So why don't we do that now if I can. Ooh. What in the world? Okay. This man was a rogue, not because circumstances forced him to be a criminal, but because he was born that way. He was probably conning his mother out of her milk the moment he could grin. He'd charm the clothes off a virgin in 20 minutes, and if the poor fool took him home, he'd drink her dad under the table, beguile her mother, charm her grandparents, and treat the girl to a night she'd never forget. In the morning, her dad would be sick with alcohol poisoning. The good silver would be missing, together with the family car. And in a month, both the former virgin and her mother would be expecting. Ilona Andrews, Faced Edge. May the spirit of the coyote bestow you its cunning, handmade with magic, with the rogue in mind. So apparently, this is coyote fur. Oh, I'm nervous now. Excited, nervous. Are you ready for this? Here's the package. Beautiful packaging. Popping this sucker open. Okay. Unrolling the magic. Jalen?
Yes.
Dice Addict Jalen?
Yes.
It's impenetrable. Okay, wait. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Feel it.
It's so soft.
It's very soft. Feel the inside.
It's really nice.
It's got a nice drawstring. Wow, look at the fur on it. Now, you know, when I asked her, I said, I didn't want to ruin anything. You know, like I really wanted to treat this with his utmost care. And I said, you know, how do I keep it clean? What do I do to care for it? And she said that, you know, a damp cloth and, you know, just stroking it clean is enough to keep it good. But she says this thing, that her products last a very long time. She hand sews each and every one of them. It's amazing. It's very nice. Look at that. Of fell and bone. And, I, you know, I checked her Etsy shop, and it's just loaded with different products that she handmade. This is fantastic. And the little story scroll about the devious, cunning coyote. That's what this is made out of. It's coyote. Wow. He probably was conning his mother out of her milk the moment he could grin. Handmade with magic, with the rogue in mind. Quite nice. Look at that. I'll be taking that to GaryCon with me next week, showing it around. Of Fell and Bone, Amber. I think she's in North Carolina, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, handmade in North Carolina. So I suggest look her up. If you've got something, she takes requests. So she will integrate materials, use whatever furs you want, or whatever materials you want, and it'll all be handmade completely. So, you know, look her up if that's something that's interesting to you, because this, I mean, this is obviously made with a lot of care. Every stitch, it's quite impressive. Wow. What do you think?
I like it.
How does it feel?
I like this.
Little drawstring, little beads.
No, like it's like the same color as the
birds. Oh, yeah, the beads do. You know I'm colorblind. Yeah, what do you do? Yeah, you know, she likes to make fun of me. You know, he can't see. That's so funny. Okay. But this is beautiful. This is beautiful. Seriously. Of Fell and Bone. Amber, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Again, Of Fell and Bone. You can also reach her at Of Fell, F-E-L-L, and Bone at gmail.com if you are interested, or at her Etsy shop.
You should put the link below.
Yeah, I'll do a little of that. Maybe you think our camera is focusing right now?
No.
No, it's not focusing.
No, it's not.
No, I'll put some information down below so that you can reach her. But in the meantime, you can find us at www.thepickledragon.com. Instagram, Facebook, all that good stuff, Twitter, you know, all that stuff.
What are you on Twitter?
I have a Twitter, yes.
Not good.
Oh, my God. Don't you have a tweeter?
No.
See? The youth of today.
Facebook's better than Twitter.
Really?
Yeah.
Facebook's better than Tweeter.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Well, you can find Dice Addict Jailed on Instagram. She promises to post more. We'll see if that happens. You know. All right. Well, thank you all. This has been a violence-free video from the Pickled Dragon. She just hit me. I'm telling mom.
I'm telling mom.